Fiki Flow Hyderabad chapter. I would like to thank everyone for having me here. It's quite overwhelming to talk in front of so many ladies. All of you know, the state of Andhra Pradesh was bifurcated in 2014, and Mr. Naidu has become the chief minister of the new state of Andhra Pradesh. In our party, we jokingly say he's a serial entrepreneur. His first venture, if I may, was Cyberabad, and we know how successful that it is today. And we've been lucky to have the second venture now called Amravati. And I think only time will tell whether it's a success or a failure. The beauty of being a new state and having the ability to govern a new state is it's a startup state. Everything is a white paper, we don't have any legacy. And I'm very lucky to have both Panchayat Raj, Rural Development and IT. And it's one of the rarest combinations that you see in Indian politics. And this is very true to our Chief Minister's heart, you know, trying to merge IT and rural development. So IT is not about, it's not just about getting the who's who to come and invest in the state, but how can we use technology, you know, to transform rural lives. And I'll give a few examples here. You know, let's just take simple things like the entire PDS system, the public distribution system that we have, you know, the ration system. It's plagued with corruption, payments are not clear, and we are the only and the first state to actually do an e-POS, electronic POS, so using biometrics of Aadhaar, they are the only state to actually distribute ration through that. Pension is also now transformed using Aadhaar gateway. And not just that, we are the first state to now launch real-time governance. We have a single number, it's 1100. So any citizen having any problem with any form at any point of governance can actually call and express their challenges. And then we have a workflow to actually resolve it. So it's not just about technology for technology. It's actually about how do we make the masses' lives a lot easier. Saying that, being a new state is very exciting. I'm not too sure how many of you have visited Vizag recently. Hood Hood is one great example. It happened in 2014, October. And we looked at it as an opportunity to transform Visakhapatnam. And if you actually go down here, it is one of the cleanest cities in the country. And it's not just that. Street lighting has been transformed to LED with sensorization. Public governance has changed. The infrastructure is completely transformed. So every crisis is an opportunity, and who better than Naidu to do it? We are only soldiers of his army, and what gives me a tremendous amount of happiness is the way he's looking at rural transformation. I'll share a few things in Panchayat Raj and rural development that we are doing. We have about 22,000 kilometers of panchayat roads, in the panchayat roads, like within the habitation. And so far, we've been able to relay close to about 13,000 kilometers. And this is all about 2 years and 4 months. And we intend to now lay all 22,000 kilometers by 2019. You won't believe, Andhra Pradesh is an unfortunate state because we don't even have one city with 100% underground drainage. But thanks to our leaders' push, all panchayats with more than 5,000 population is going to get underground drainage. We are going to lay 10,000 kilometers of underground drainage in the next 2 years. Which means I'll pretty much suck every production pipe that's going to come out, which is meant for underground drain in the country. So what our leader believes is, it's not just about the urban clusters, but even rural clusters have to thrive. And he has come up with a 7-star formula, where it starts from simple electrification, to rural infrastructure, lighting, LPG, to the most important star, which is creating 10,000 rupees income per household per month. That's something that's very, very close to us. A lot of entrepreneurs here, I would love to hear a lot of ideas to do this. I've had an opportunity to talk to Kamini about it in the Weavers. You know, how can we now integrate everything? You know, he's big into now silk. And we were just talking about how do we create a silk cluster. And then put the entire might of government behind it to actually get this cluster going. So we are big believers of cluster, and we are believers of decentralized development. Just to give an idea, Visakhapatnam is going to be our IT and med devices and pharma hub. Amravati is going to be more like a Washington DC, where all the regulatory and specialized technologies, very specialized manufacturing will come. Rayalaseema, which is the four districts, is predominantly transformed into a manufacturing hub. We've been lucky to get Foxconn. Kia is starting up their facility. We're hoping to roll out the first Kia by 2018. Saying this, it is a challenging time, but it's a very exciting time. I keep saying government has a lot of money, but we don't know how to spend it. And that's where our leader looks at private sector involvement. So if you look at my ministries, I have four major ministries: Panchayat Raj, Rural Development, IT and Electronics. Across all our ministries, we're looking at private engagement and interaction. Just starting from basic policies to working together with the private sector on creating technology for the masses. So if you can create a sensor that would work in rural India, believe me, you can market it anywhere. Because they would ask at a price point which is unbeatable, and it has to stand the wear and tear of rural India, which is very difficult. It's much better than German labs. So, that's where I think it gets very exciting. And as a state, we are at the forefront of using such technologies in rural India. So I'm looking forward to hearing from you. Women empowerment is something very, very close to our family's heart, and it's not just talk. I know every politician says that, but we do walk the talk. I almost got work the talk. Mom has been with Heritage for now almost 2.5 decades. She runs it day to day. I think after Brahmani came in, she got a bit of time off. And now Brahmani, being the ED, has been running it day to day. And we're very lucky because they make the money and Dad and I can spend it. I hope Brahmi doesn't block my credit card after this event. So I think we've been very lucky, political family, in that sense. One word that comes up when you say politics is corruption. And we've been very lucky because we have hardworking women at home getting us the bread, and we men can actually spend it. We are also firm believers, because it starts with leadership in any political establishment. Once the leadership is aligned, then it sort of percolates downward. The biggest challenge that we've seen with women reservation is that quite a few of them are made dummies. And that's something that really does disappoint our leader and me personally. So when we have our training programs or when we have interaction with women politicians, we ensure their their better halves are not there in that meeting. So you say, it's time that you talk. It's time that you take charge. Yes, you take advice. And that's something that we've been working very closely, on the party side. So it's not about filling up quotas. That's something that's very close to us. It's about actually empowering them to take decisions, empowering them to question the way we do things. Even within the party, we are sort of empowering women to do this. We have training camps specifically for women to come and talk about issues that women face. But there's this whole discussion about, as simple as, can we now do sanitary napkin distribution via PDS, public distribution system? Because these are the basic things that, sitting at the highest level, we might not understand. But hearing it out from the masses and people who have actually know the challenge and who experience it, it's amazing the transformation they can have. Just talking about the entire Anganwadis, the Anganwadi system that we have in India, the ICDS system. AP government is pushing pregnant women nutrition in a very, very big way. It's probably because now Dad is very close to Devansh than he was to me. So he knows the importance of nutrition. I think I'll let Brahmi talk about that, because it's very close to her heart. But, it's all about when we form policies, when it comes to execution, we fumble. And that's where, getting feedback from the grassroots, and especially women, has been very instrumental, even from a government standpoint. Saying that, I don't want to bore you with too many details. But it is exciting times as a country. We did, the speech did, the speaker did talk about political volatility. We don't have that in India anymore. We are blessed. I think we have strong leadership at the national level, very clear leadership at the national level. And that enables states like Andhra Pradesh to really move forward. And as he keeps saying, it's not about money. Because the capital Amravati has been able to do land pooling of 33,000 acres without spending a penny, without buying land. There is a cost associated with the program, but acquiring 33,000 acres in that district is virtually impossible. It would cost about 100,000 crores, which is impossible. But we're able to do this because people believe. So it's all about innovative ideas. And these ideas actually came from the public. The ideas actually came from the public, and our leader, even at 67, is like a youngster. Keep saying, you know, it's very tough working with him. You know, I feel he's like a 24-year-old running. Me being 34, I'm not able to catch up with him. So he loves ideas coming from the field, and you know, he really takes that and he absorbs it and he lives it. And for him, he only says one thing. In modern India, post-independent India, I think Amravati will be the second capital that we're building after Chandigarh. And we are lucky to be part of that. And that's something that he lives and breathes every day. And I'm looking forward to hearing from all of you on what we can do better.